qubit value, that is hexadecimal value. So we are going to move that value to P2, okay? And if such is equal to 1, send letter Y to P2, okay? So here P1.7 is an input port, okay? P2 will be your output port. So first step is you have to configure this P1.7 as an input port, okay? So that is your first step. Make P1.7 an input port. And after that, you have to monitor this P1.7, not 1.2, here P1.7. Okay, so monitor your P1.7. If this bit is equal to 1, P1.7 is equal to 1, means your program control transfer to over here. So it will come here and transferring this Y to P2 based on your condition given in the problem statement. Okay. Suppose if it fails, P1.7 is equal to, sorry, here P1.7 is equal to 1 means your program control goes to over and writing this data Y to P2. Okay. Suppose if P1.7 is equal to 0, that case is jump no bit condition. For that, these two instruction will get executed, that is writing N to P2, again it will continuously monitor the P1.7. Okay, any doubts? So first you have to configure the input port and monitor your input port continuously. If the bit is 1, means you have to move this character, particular character Y, otherwise you have to move the character N, that's all. So a character is not in the form of alphabets, in the form of hexadecimal value. We cannot assign a character value in our microcontroller programming. So N is nothing but some hexadecimal value. Is that clear? Okay. So next problem. A switch is connected to P1.0 and an LED is connected to P2.7. So according to this problem statement, which one is input port and which one is output port? Please tell me. So two ports involved here. So two ports are involved here. One is P1.0, other one is P2.7. The switch is connected to P1.0 and LED is connected to P2.7. So which one is input and which one is output? P1 is input, P2 is output. There's 1.0 as an input and 2.7 as an output. So here you have to read the status. You have to get the status of switch and send it to the LED. That is the problem statement. Okay, so the important point is here, we cannot transfer the data straight away between your port pins. This cannot be possible according to your instruction set. So intermediate, we have to use some bit registers, bit handling registers, to transfer the data between port pins. For that case, I have used carry bit. So read the status of P1.0 and transfer that status to carry. After that, carry to 2.7. So two instructions are required in order to transfer the data between two port pins. Okay. Again, you repeat the same instruction. So the first step will be input configuration. Any doubts? Other students, if you have any doubts, you can ask. This is a very important topic in 8051 microcontroller. Port programming is very important. Okay. So next one, so it's like application oriented. So P2.2 is used to control an outdoor light. Okay. And bit 2.5, a light inside a building. Okay. Show how to turn on outside light and turn off inside one. So according to the problem, so P2.2 is used to control your outdoor light. P2.5 is for indoor. So indoor. So here you have to turn on your outdoor light, outside light, and turn off your indoor light. So two status. Okay. So in case of considering this outdoor P2.2. Okay. So the condition given here is you have to turn on P2.2. So two possibilities according to your statement, whether the particular light may be already turned on, otherwise may be already turned off. That case, okay, either off or on, but the output should be in on. Okay, so for that you have to, so which logic can be applied? R logic can be applied. Okay. 1 R with 0, the output will be on. 1 R with 1, output will be on. So based on the input conditions. So sometimes the light may be turned on already. Okay. Or otherwise it may be turned off already. But what will be your output? The output is going to be 1. Okay. For that case, you have to R 1 with the status of P2.2. 1 R with 0, the output will be 1. 1 R with 1, output will be 1. Is that clear? Any doubts? So P2.2 reflects your outdoor light condition. Okay. அது எப்படி இருக்கும்னா, either it will it may be in turned on condition or turned off condition. So your output is going to be 1. So that case you have to apply your R logic. So the first statement, you have to set your carry flag. I'm using this carry bit for this R logic. Carry R with your P2.2. Carry R with P2.2 status. Okay. So set bit carry. So the carry should be 1 here. So R C comma P2.2. So P2.2 R with carry. And move that carry status to P2.2. So turn it on if not already on. That is the meaning. So for that situation, we have to apply R. Is that okay? So next case, so your P2.2 case status may be 0 and 1. So the output should be in 0. That is in logic low. For that case, so what logic can be applied? Irrespective of your input, what logic can be applied? AND logic can be applied. So clear carry. So 0 AND with 0, your output will be 0. 0 AND with 1, your output will be 0. So clear carry. Move this your carry with 2.5, that is 2.5 AND with your carry, and turn off the light. Already, if not, this statement will turn off the light. Move P2.5 comma carry. So two logic can be applied. One is R logic, another one is the AND logic. Okay. R logic is for turn on your outside light. AND logic is for turn off your inside light. Okay. Is that clear? So jump bit P2.2 L1. Clear P2.5. Okay. Suppose if the bit is equal to 1, set bit P2.2. Okay. But here again you have to use jump below the state, set BP2.2. So for different scenarios, different condition, you have to apply. So this program will reflect how to use your AND and OR logic for particular real-time application. You can use set bit and clear bit, but this case, it's based on logic levels. Okay. So next one, switch is connected to port pin 0.1. So write a program to check the status of the switch and perform the following. So if a switch is going to be 1, send high to low pulse to activate siren connected to pin P1.7. Okay, and continue monitoring pin status. So here the condition given is you have to use carry flag to check the switch status. Okay. So here input port is P0.1 and your output port P1.7. So you have to monitor your P0.1 continuously. Okay. And you have to use the carry flag to check the status of this particular P0.1. So based on your configuration logic, first you make this P0.1 as an input port pin for accepting input from the external device. Okay. So let's assume a switch is connected. Okay. And next, transferring this P0.1 to carry flag. Okay. Jump no carry means it's continuously checking the status of P0.7. If carry is not set, if carry is zero, it will again and again checking the status of your carry flag. If carry is set, the condition is false, so it will execute this particular instruction, set bit P1.7. Call delay and clear P1.7. So these three statements is used to generate high to low pulse with some amount of delay. Please note down the answer. So if you have any free time, kindly check your results using our IDE. 8051 microcontroller IDE. Any doubts? Any doubts in bit manipulation instructions? So shall we move on to the logical? So logical is the last part of your instruction set. Okay. So we have three main logical instructions and our XR. Already you were aware of these instruction, and remaining instruction clear, complement accumulator, rotate left accumulator, rotate left through carry, rotate right accumulator, and rotate right through carry and swap instruction. Okay. So regarding these three instruction and our Excel, just I will highlight the application of these instruction, how these instructions can be used in microcontroller applications. Okay. So this is the syntax. Already you were aware of this ANL instruction. So A comma hash data, A comma general purpose register, A comma direct address, A comma indirect address. And your destination may be a direct address, direct comma A and direct comma hash data. Please note down the addressing modes and number of bytes and number of clock cycles, machine cycles. So the syntax given here is ANL, destination comma source. Okay. So the operation here is the destination register or destination operand and with source operand, and result will be holded by destination operand. So this will perform logical AND on the two operands and place the result in the destination. So destination is normally the accumulator according to your syntax. Some case we can use these two instruction, but destination will be a direct address. Okay. So the source operand can be a register or memory or immediate operands. So look at this example. So what is the purpose of this ANL in microcontrollers means? It's mainly for masking certain bits, either LSB or MSB. Okay. Using this instruction, we can disable certain bits of an operand. Okay. So move A comma hash 35 and AND A comma hash 0F. So when we are ANDing this 0F with 35, okay, your MSB is masked. Please look at 35 and 0F. So 35, 0F, the result is 05. So this is completely masked. Masked means disabled. So suppose if you want to mask your LSB, what is your source operand? Can you understand my question? So according to this example, your MSB is masked. Suppose if you want to mask your LSB, what is your source operand? F0. Okay. So you have to thirty-five F 0 3 0 result will be 3 0. LSB is masked. In this way, we can separate our LSB and MSB. Okay, so that is the application of AND logics in 8051 microcontrollers. So next instruction, OR instruction. So the syntax is ORL, destination comma source. So destination OR with source. So the destination is normally the accumulator, similar to AND. Just you note down the all the syntax, data, general purpose register, direct address, indirect address, direct comma A and direct comma hash data. So the application of OR instruction, so this instruction can be used to set an bits of an operand to 1. So here, look at this example, this particular bits D6, D5 and D4. So all the bits are set to 1 based on OR logic. So this instruction can be applied to this particular application. So we can make certain bits to be 1. Next, XR. The syntax are similar to your R and ANL, data, register, direct, indirect, and direct comma A, direct comma hash data. So this will perform XR operation. So your syntax, destination, XRL, destination comma source. So destination XR with source and result will be holded by destination. So the application, so it can be used to toggle certain bits of an operand. Suppose 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. So here all the 4 bits are 1. So 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So toggling the bits 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So we can toggle the certain bits of an operand. For this application, XRL can be used. And also another application to clear the contents of register, XR instructions can be used. Suppose move a comma hash 35, okay, XRL a comma hash 35. So 35 XR with 35 means your accumulator is clear. For that purpose, XRL instructions can be used. The number XR with the same number means the result will be 0. So that is the main purpose. For that, XRL instructions are used to clear the content of your registers. So these are the applications of AND, ORL and XR instruction. So next one is the clear complement accumulator and swap instruction. So already you are aware of this instruction, clear A. So this instruction is used to clear your accumulator, and complement A, it is used to find the ones complement of accumulator content. Okay. So these two instruction only work on accumulator alone. Okay. Next, swap A instruction, just swapping the LSB and MSB. So before execution, D7 to D4, D3 to D0. So after execution, this D0 will be placed in the place of D7 to D4. Similarly, it is exchanged in the place of D3 to D0. Just exchanging your LSB and MSB. Example, suppose 53, your input data is 53. After execution, this will be exchanged, so 35. So LSB is exchanged with MSB, that's all. Any doubts up to this, any doubts? So next instructions are rotate instruction. So we have 4 instruction: rotate accumulator left, rotate accumulator left through carry, rotate accumulator right, and rotate accumulator right through carry. So these instruction only work on accumulator register, not any other register. Okay. So number of bytes taken 1, and number of machine cycles required 1. Okay, so this addressing mode is not defined by your Intel, but it belongs to implicit addressing mode. Okay, here there is no destination operand or no source operand. So the syntax is RLA, rotate left accumulator. So just you look at this diagram. So 8 bits of the accumulator are rotated left 1 bit. Okay, that is D7 is transferred to D0, that is, it enters into D0, and the bits are shifted from LSB to MSB. Okay, from right to left. So in this example, 72. Okay, 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0. Okay, so the first step would be 0 is transferred in the place of D0. Okay, and this should be shifted to next place, 0 1 0 0 1 1 1. So this will be your output after the execution of first. So next one, this one will come at the place of D0. So 1, and these bits are shifted from right to left. So 0 0 1 0 0 1 1. So the bits are moving from your MSB to LSB. So that is the concept. So carry flag is not affected by this instruction. Just 8 bits of the accumulator are rotated, left 1 bit. Suppose if you want to rotate the numbers in more times, you have to include more number of RLA instructions. Suppose you want to rotate the accumulator content 3 times, you have to use RLA, RLA, RLA. Is that clear? Any doubts? So next one, rotate left through carry. So the operation is similar to previous one, but the only the difference is the MSB is placed in carry and carry to LSB, and shift the bits are shifted from LSB to MSB. Shifted from right to left. So they exit the MSB and enter the carry flag, and carry enters into LSB. So in previous 72, take that example, 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0. The carry is cleared, set to 1, for example, set to 1. So according to this statement, so this 0 is transferred to carry and 1 is placed at the place of D0. Okay, 0 1 0 0 1 1 1. Operation is similar to the previous instruction, but the thing is your MSB is transferred to carry, carry to LSB, and LSB to MSB. Okay, and next, rotate right accumulator. So here LSB to MSB and bits are shifted from left to right. So look at the example, move A, #36. So the binary 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 0. So first LSB is 0, so that is placed in the place of D7, and the bits are rotated from your left side to left hand side to left side to right side. Please note down this example. Next, rotate right through carry. The operation is similar to the previous one. The difference is the LSP. They exit the LSP to the carry flag and carry flag to MSB and MSB to LSP. Here carry flag will be affected. Please note down this example. So bits are shifted through carry from left to right. So note down the homework problem. So we will discuss the answer in the tomorrow's class. Write a program that finds the number of ones in a given byte. We find the number of ones in a given byte. So use rotate instruction for this particular application. So you have to rotate the number through carry and check the carry flag. Based on the carry flag status, you increment the register. Use rotate left or right through carry instruction and check the carry flag status. Okay. And take down this problem statement. Answer your attendance one.
Problem number one, present, ma'am.
Two, present, ma'am.
Three,
present, ma'am.
Four, five,
present, ma'am.
Six,
present, ma'am.
Seven, eight, nine,
present, ma'am.
10,
present, ma'am.
11, 12,
present, ma'am. 12, present, ma'am.
Okay, 13,
13, present, ma'am. Ma'am, 13, present, ma'am.
Okay, pa, okay. 14,
14, present, ma'am.
15, 1 second.